Okay, nobody said that there would be jump scares.
Hello, my name is Miss Beacon, and welcome back to part 3 of Detroit Become Human. Now, in part 2, I had to chop up a little bit of the Let's Play because I wasn't watching my time, and I kind of let it go a little bit too far, but I also didn't want to, like, leave it in the middle of the story, so I had to chop up a little bit. But basically what happened in the previous part is we left off with Kara and Alice. They decided to sleep in the car, and we're trying to be good androids here. Like, I don't want to steal or anything, so I will let you guys go ahead and watch this next part.
So, welcome back to part 3. We just had found the little girl. I can't remember her name. We had just found a place for her to sleep. It took me kind of a while because I wasn't sure if I needed to stay, like, in a particular place. There was an option for me to, like, steal and stuff. So I was like, no, I'm going to be a good android. I'm going to do what I would do. You know what I mean? So it's November 6th. Did I record? Okay, I just had to make sure I was recording, but it is November 6th. We need a reboot. Whoever this is. Oh, he's still alive? He's still alive. Oh. Corrupted audio data damaged. Corrupted mind palace. So impaired vision. Lower power mode defective. Unable to stand because his legs are all freaking chopped off. At least he's not able to, like, feel, you know what I mean? He said something. That guy said something. Oh my gosh! There's people looking at him. This is so weird. Oh my gosh, that scared me.
There's a place where we can be free. Find Jericho! Find Jericho!
Oh my gosh, that scared me.
I
That is so creepy. Gosh, that's so creepy. She don't need it no more. Free off. Still our eyeballs too. Just kidding. Anyways. Tell me to look there. Do I need something? Gotta find pair of eyes and spare parts. I gotta replace the damaged parts before I climb up. I guess he's gonna be live. Oh. Oh, we can hear now. Need to find some eyes. Yay!
Hello, I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you?
Give me your eye.
Hello. I'm an AK-700 Andrew. My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife Maintenance Center.
Did it. At least the combos, like, aren't really that difficult to remember. He's free! Can make himself look human. Whoa. His name is Marcus. All right, so we're gonna keep on a truckin' this November 6th. He's alive? Oh, they probably just rebuilt him or something.
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Your predecessor was unfortunately destroyed. It knew deviants could be unpredictable, but it wasn't careful enough. I hope you won't make the same mistake.
I don't intend to.
When a Connor model is destroyed, its memory is transferred to the next one. But some data can be lost in the process. Avoid being destroyed. It would be better for you and the investigation.
I understand.
The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the Deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will adapt to his personality. It is in the best interest of the investigation that I avoid conflict and try to accommodate his psychology.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Pick up the investigation where the previous Connor left off and put a stop to this.
Oh.
Hurry, all right. Connor.
Yeah, hurry.
There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
He might be in shock.
Shh. Triggs has spoken of intolerable provocation. It cannot go unanswered. The countries in the region, particularly Sweden and Canada, have called for military forces to withdraw and an international conference to be held. So far, there has been no response from either.
Found his desk. Let's go.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
You and you come.
Thanks.
With me.
Sure.
You okay? Listen.
We're just analyzing stuff. UT Android 7.
Hello, Lieutenant. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
God, I saw you get shot in the head last night.
My predecessor was unfortunately destroyed, but CyberLife transferred its memory and sent me to replace it. This incident should not affect the investigation.
Oh, Jesus.
Hank! In my office!
Maybe they're trying out a new form of red ice. You really need the forensics.
I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link. Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified guy.
What are you looking at? Hey, fuck you!
Let's see. So I guess I'm just trying to observe, like, what happened to my dumb self that died. No, I don't want to exit.
Listen, I know you don't like me, but we're going to have to work together. We'll both have to make an effort. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Thank you. have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hair's on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh. Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah. Too long.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
If you have any files on Deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Plaintiff claims he was violently attacked by his domestic Android NAX-400 model. The Android was returned from being repaired the previous day and shows signs of aggression in the past.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. Shouldn't let your personal situation hamper the investigation, Lieutenant.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about. So why don't you just run your program and shut the fuck up?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Yeah.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
Oh no!
I'm on it.
That's my chick. That's me. All right, Hank got a lead. I thought it was just going to be that one android that it was going to be that didn't get killed because I'm dumb. But it ended up being all of them. All of them are still alive, so. I guess it just takes a lot to kill an android. So it's November 6th, 2038. And it is 10:25 a.m. Canada is still Android free, apparently. Why did to cut my hair. So why would I need that? Let's go with white. We're gonna go with white hair. Looks like there's something in the back of the car, question mark? I forgot where I put the tool. There we go. Thank you. The little girl's gonna freak out. Why didn't you do that when she was awake?
Android we saw yesterday. He gave me an address. He said we could get help there. The train passes just on the other side of the road. The station can't be far. You feel okay to walk a little? Let's go then.
Yeah, let's go take a stroll.
Pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
The police are on our trail.
All right. That's all for now. Ready to go.
We've got officers sweeping the neighborhood in case anybody saw anything.
Okay, well, let me know if they turn anything up.
What are you gonna do with that?
I have no idea.
It took the first bus that came along and stayed at the end of the line. Its decision wasn't planned. It was driven by fear.
Androids don't feel fear.
Deviants do. They get overwhelmed by their emotions and make irrational decisions.
All right, well, that still doesn't tell us where it went.
It didn't have a plan, and it had nowhere to go. Maybe it didn't go far.
Maybe.
Interesting.
For the train station.
No, I don't want to catch him. No.
They're over there.
Shoot, we need it alive!
Oh, fuck! That's insane!
Oh my gosh!
Let them get away.
They won't. They'll never make it to the other side.
I can't take that chance.
Now you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor. That's an order.
Yeah. like, oh, freak. I'm getting good at this.
Are you okay?
Interesting. Well, since we have 12 more minutes left, we're gonna try and get through another one before the time runs up.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station.
Oh, yeah? What do you say? Really? Not surprised. Apparently she did. Yeah. I know. It's crazy, right?
Did it. I keep going silent because, like, I don't know, it's just interesting. I didn't see what that one was. It's like half the lion.
Sorry. Excuse me.
We're getting somewhere. Mm-hmm. Okay, now what? I've got another symbol. Next symbol. Okay, I wasn't sure if I was supposed to go like under there or not, but it looks like I am. So are getting somewhere. All right. This other symbol is. Oh, there it is. How many flipping clues are there? So I'm probably gonna have to go up the ladder, question mark? Yep. Okay. did it. Fell off. I'm learning. No fear.
Oh.
Okay, nobody said there would be jump scares. Break. They're gonna like think he's human or something because he doesn't have his thing on. Okay, boo.
Welcome to Jericho.
We're at Jericho now, woohoo! So, that is all for this part, and I'll see you guys in the next video.